Fala pessoal, tudo bem? Welcome to Uncle Brazil. My name is Rodrigo, and today we are going to see 11 Brazilian Portuguese expressions. You're going to learn how to connect with a Brazilian local. But first of all, I invite you to subscribe to my channel and, after the video, leave your thumbs up if you like it. Now, vamos nessa! And the first expression is: Isso custa os olhos da cara. Isso custa os olhos da cara. It costs the face eyes. When we want to say that something costs too much, we use this expression. Possible translation: It costs an arm and a leg. Example: This shirt costs an arm and a leg. Esta camisa custa os olhos da cara. Eu te dou a mão e você quer o braço. Eu te dou a mão e você quer o braço. This is the second expression. I give you my hand and you want my arm. Brazilians use this expression when they mean that someone is asking for more than what was offered. The connotation of this expression is bad, as we are usually referring to an ungrateful person. Possible translation: I give you an inch and you want a mile. Example: Son, I just gave you 50 reais. And you are asking me for another 50 reais? I give you an inch and you want a mile. Filho, eu acabei de te dar 50 reais e você está me pedindo mais 50 reais. Eu te dou a mão e você quer o braço. The third expression is dor de cotovelo. Dor de cotovelo. Elbow pain. This expression is used to say that someone is jealous or envious of someone. Both in the sense of love and in the sense of envy for something important that has been conquered by someone else. For example, possible translation: to be green with envy. Example: he got a new job, but it's not even that good. Stop! You are green with envy. Ele conseguiu um emprego novo, mas nem é tão bom assim. Para! Você tá com dor de cotovelo. Pulga atrás da orelha. Pulga atrás da orelha. This is the expression number four. I have a flea behind my ear. When we are suspicious of someone or something, we use this expression. Possible translation: my spidey senses are tingling. Example: my boss called me to an emergency meeting today. What will it be? My spidey senses are tingling. Meu chefe me chamou para uma reunião de emergência hoje. O que será? Tô com a pulga atrás da orelha. Vou te dar uma mão. Vou te dar uma mão. This is the expression number five. I'll give you a hand. This expression is used when we are going to offer help to someone. Possible translation: I'll give you a hand. Example: Are you in doubt on this issue? Calm down. I'll give you a hand. Você está com dúvida nessa questão? Calma, eu vou te dar uma mão. Cabeça dura. Cabeça dura. Strong head. Brazilians use this expression to refer to someone who is stubborn. Possible translations: strong-headed, stubborn. Example: I've told you 10 times to take a flu medicine and you don't want to take it. You are very stubborn. Eu já te disse 10 vezes para tomar um remédio para gripe e você não quer tomar. Você é muito cabeça dura. Perna de pau. Perna de pau. Wooden leg. This expression is often related to soccer, referring to someone who plays very poorly. Possible translation: you suck. Example: dude, try another sport, because in soccer you suck. Cara, tenta outro esporte, porque no futebol você é muito perna de pau. Coração mole. Coração mole. This is the expression number eight. Soft heart. This expression is used to refer to someone who is easily moved and emotional. Possible translation: softy. Example: my friend can't see a romance movie that starts crying. She's a softy. Minha amiga não pode ver um filme de romance que começa a chorar. É muito coração mole. Coração de pedra. Coração de pedra. Heart of stone. Unlike the previous expression, coração de pedra is used for people without feeling. Possible translation: cold-hearted. Example: his ex-girlfriend was crying, wanting to talk to him, and he didn't want to. He's very cold-hearted. A ex-namorada dele estava chorando, querendo conversar com ele, e ele não quis. É muito coração de pedra. Mão na massa. Mão na massa. This is the expression number 10. Hands on dough. Used when we are going to start something, such as a project, a study, or work. Possible translation: let's get to work. Example: it's already 9 a.m. and I have to get to work. Let's get to work. Já são 9 da manhã e eu tenho que começar a trabalhar. Mão na massa. And the last expression is: não coloca o nariz onde não é chamado. Não coloca o nariz onde não é chamado. Don't put your nose where you're not required. This expression is used when we want to tell someone not to meddle in whatever is going on. Possible translation: mind your own business. Example: this fight is between me and her. Mind your own business. Essa briga é entre mim e ela. Não coloque o nariz onde você não é chamado. É isso, pessoal. Thanks for watching. I hope you liked. I hope it helped you. And I also invite you to visit me on my other medium. I have a blog. I have an Instagram where I write about Portuguese, about Brazil. I'm pretty sure that you like it. Okay? See you in the next video. Valeu!